Hey guys, how's it going? Noir with Garden Answers. So it's currently right at the end of August, and this little area behind me that's so beautiful has gone through quite the transformation over the past like 9 or 10 months. So what I really wanted to do today is go back in time and kind of show you the whole process and how it's evolved. Hey guys, welcome back to another video on this very bright and sunny November day. It's perfect out here for gardening, so I thought it'd be a great time to tackle this small landscape project in our formal garden. So the first thing I need to do is get this sod out, and I'm gonna go ask Aaron to help me with this part. All right, so these are the plants that are gonna be in this area. I'm gonna start with a boxwood hedge. These are sprinter boxwoods. So these will line the entire perimeter of this spot. And then I'm gonna back plant these with the denim and lace Russian sage. Really excited to get this in here. I'm actually inspired by Ina Gartens, the Barefoot Contessa's garden. She's got boxwood hedge with Russian sage planted, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. So it inspired me to plant a little area like that in my garden. And then I've got 90 of these tulips. These are Cafe Noir, really beautiful, deep, deep kind of burgundy color. So we'll have some spring color in here as well as summer. So I'm just gonna set all of these plants out and get them in the ground. All the plants are spaced out, and I used 7 of the Russian sage, and they're approximately 3 feet apart, and this is my measurement. Like, one large step usually equals about 3 feet, so it's roughly 3 feet apart. And then I used my trowel as my spacing tool for my boxwoods. They're about 1.5 feet apart, and that's a little bit closer than you might plant them if you were wanting something a little bit more open, or if you were wanting it to take a little bit longer to be a hedge, but I want it to be a hedge pretty quickly. So now I'm gonna plant. Now that I've got all of those things planted, I'm gonna plant my bulbs. To do that, I've got 90 tulip bulbs to go all the way around the circle, and I wanna make sure I do it pretty evenly. So I'm gonna kind of divide it into quarters and then separate these bulbs into 22 each, so that makes 88. It's pretty close, so I'll have 2 extra bulbs. But that way I'll have it pretty uniformly spread around the circle. So I'm gonna do that first, and then I'm gonna plant them using my auger on the end of my drill. It makes making the tulip holes, or the holes for the tulips, a lot easier. If you haven't ever done this before, check out our video that we recently posted on how to plant bulbs, and I talk a lot more about it. Okay, so it's the next day because we were losing light really quickly last night. So the last step is mulching, and that's really important to do for any new planting and really for any existing plantings in your garden, because it not only makes everything look really pretty and tidy, but it also provides a little bit of extra winter protection, and it provides some good stuff for the soil, especially for these boxwoods, which are naturally shallow rooted plants, so they really benefit from a good 2-inch layer of mulch in the fall. Okay guys, look at how this bed has turned out. Do you remember when I planted this last fall? Aaron and I removed a bunch of grass that was around it, and we planted it. So I did 7 denim and lace Russian sage, which they're all coming back. There's green growth at the base of each one of those plants. And then 90 Cafe Noir tulips, which I think every single one of them came up and they're all blooming right now. And I just love it. All of the sprinter boxwoods made it. And you guys, the snow was up to here. I was like just sweating bullets all winter. I thought, oh great, that snow just like flattened all my boxwoods. All of them survived. There's no winter kill on them. So, I mean, this is my first in-ground landscape planting of sprinter boxwoods that I've ever done for that variety. And I'm a believer. So you might remember last fall, we did a little mini makeover right here. There was just grass that we removed. We've started with the 7 denim and lace Russian sage, which is a smaller growing Russian sage, doesn't get quite as tall. I've really enjoyed that. The honeybees have loved it. And then right in front of that, we planted 90 Cafe Noir tulips, which are all still there. They bloomed beautifully this spring. When I cut them back, I went in with some annuals, which I love. I love this combination. So we've got some White Knight Alyssum and some Supertunia Bordeaux. And I think that this mix is just so sparkly and beautiful. I really am thrilled with how it turned out and just how it looks. especially when the Russian sage, it's almost like kind of blooming out right now, but when it was in its full purple glory, it was amazing, you guys. And then of course, right in front here, we've got the sprinter boxwood, which when I planted them, they were probably like half the size that they are now. And this was just last fall. So the fact that they all made it through our 52 inches of snow with nothing broken or damaged or dead on them was amazing. So that made me a believer, a believer in this variety. So it's August now, and I know it hasn't changed a ton since the July garden tour, but the flowers have grown a little bit more. There's a little bit more bloom and color on them. And I expect to get quite a bit more time out of them. Probably a good two and a half months, because both the supertunias and the lobularia here can take quite a hard frost before they'll be done for the year. And at that point, I'll go in and clean those out. I'll cut the Russian sage back quite close to the ground. And I'm just excited to kind of see the boxwoods form a hedge, see the tulips come back up. I might add a few more tulips this fall as well, depending on if I can get a hold of the same variety. I kind of like to beef up the amount that's in here. But I just hope that seeing this transformation, not even a year after we started it, is an encouragement to you guys, because this is how our gardens start. They start small in baby form. And you know, we just kind of do things to fill up the space before our big plants, you know, have grown to their mature size. And it's fun to see. I love to see people's gardens in process. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.